You're logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for global Indians. We broadcast news from India, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati languages. And our portal and apps have a list of well-established businesses and resources that every global Indian needs. I'm Prerna Sharma and today's headlines are: In India, the Congress-JDS combined has dealt a blow to the BJP with a 4-1 win in the Karnataka by-polls. And Faizabad in Uttar Pradesh will now be known as Ayodhya. In Punjab, Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has reviewed security due to the high alert on Diwali. And SHOs will be held responsible if the SE directive on crackers is violated. In Canada, sexual allegations have led to two high-profile resignations. And two BC residents have appealed against extradition to India. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, Canada and Punjab. For detailed news and business updates of the Indo-Canadian community, download the Indian Times Daily app.
Have you been denied long-term disability benefits or have your benefits been terminated? If your claim for disability benefits is denied, you should be given a reason. Insurance companies have an internal appeal process. However, it is difficult to alter their decision using this internal process. Therefore, we recommend retaining a lawyer immediately after your claim is terminated or denied. Call an experienced long-term disability claims lawyer at Kotak Personal Injury Law. We will fight for your right to receive the benefits you deserve.
Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: Karnataka's JDS Congress coalition has won two of the three Lok Sabha seats and both the assembly constituencies in the fiercely fought by-polls. The BJP suffered an embarrassing reverse in Ballari, a seat it had been winning since 2004. Faizabad in Uttar Pradesh will be known as Ayodhya. Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath has said in a speech to mark Diwali festival in the holy city revered by millions of Hindus as the birthplace of Lord Ram. The announcement comes days after the Uttar Pradesh government officially renamed Allahabad as Prayagraj. Congress President Rahul Gandhi has alleged that Prime Minister Narendra Modi was trying to fix the mess his genius economic theories have created by seeking 3.6 lakh crore rupees from the RBI. As per a report, the Finance Ministry has sent a proposal to the RBI seeking the amount to recapitalize public sector banks. Two Hizbul Mujahideen militants, including an army deserter, have been killed in a gunfight in South Kashmir, Shopian district. The gunfight erupted when police and security forces launched a cordon and search operation in the pre-dawn hours based on inputs about the presence of militants. Former RBI Governor Raghuram Rajan has said that the central bank is like a seatbelt in a car, without which accidents can happen. Pitching for respecting its institutional autonomy, he said that the RBI has the liberty to say no if the government pushes it to be lenient. The ED has arrested from Kolkata a director of a shell company of fugitive diamond heir Mehul Choksi in the 13,500 crore rupees PNB fraud case. He was also made an accused in the charge sheet filed against Choksi and a non-bailable warrant was issued against him. Journalists were reportedly heckled during protests at Sabarimala after reports of a woman below 50 years attempting to enter the temple circulated. The SC has allowed women of menstruating age group to enter the shrine, but none have been able to make it to its hallowed precincts due to protests. Former National Conference leader Junaid Azim Mattu, who quit the party to contest the urban local body polls, has been elected mayor of the Srinagar Municipal Corporation. He was backed by the BJP and the People's Conference. Rohit Sharma has achieved twin milestones. First, by surpassing Captain Virat Kohli to become India's highest run scorer in T20 internationals, followed by most number of centuries in shortest format. Rohit hit an unbeaten 111 off 61 balls to complete his fourth ton in T20 internationals. When he reached a personal score of 11, he surpassed Kohli's Indian record of 2,101 runs. With Diwali comes the victory of light over darkness, good over evil and knowledge over ignorance. This year, amidst wishing prosperity and success, Bollywood celebrities have urged their fans a noise-free and an animal-friendly Diwali. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Punjab and Canada follows.
Realize your ambition of becoming a doctor at All Saints University School of Medicine. With small class sizes, affordable tuition and worldwide clinical clerkships, All Saints University brings a world of opportunity right to your feet. University and high school graduates are eligible for admission. To learn more, call us at 416-743-9222 or visit us at www.allsaintsuniversity.org.
Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has directed the police to remain on high alert for Diwali celebrations in the light of recent attempts to foment trouble in state. The attempts were allegedly made by hardliners backed by inimical forces from across the border. The station house officer of the police station concerned will be held responsible if SA directions regarding the permitted period for bursting firecrackers is violated. All authorities concerned have been asked to stop bursting of crackers beyond the permitted period from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. The headmaster and a teacher of Government Girls' School in Fazilka have been suspended for allegedly stripping of girls after the discovery of a sanitary pad in a school toilet. The suspension came following the directions of Chief Minister Amrinder Singh. Rebel Aam Aadmi Party MLA Sukhpal Singh Khera and Kavar Sandhu have questioned their suspension from the party, even as they paraded six MLAs of their group. Khera and Sandhu have also dismissed reports that two MLAs from their group had returned to Kejriwal's supported state Aam Aadmi Party group. The Punjab and Haryana High Court has directed secretaries of health and education departments to remain present in a case pertaining to finalization of curriculum modules. The directions came for the curriculum of the 2018-19 academic session. Health Minister Brahm Mohindra has held local bodies and rural development departments responsible for dengue outbreak in the state. Mahendra blamed the departments during a meeting of state task force convened to take stock of preparedness in controlling dengue outbreak. INLD leader Ajay Chautala will announce his decision over the sacking of his grandson and his brother from party on November 17. Chautala claimed that his supporters are being humiliated at party events. Farmers have protested against the state at 40 places in 13 districts over paddy being rejected on grounds of high moisture content. They blocked traffic on roads for several hours. Farmers have been protesting for almost a week now. The BSF has nabbed a Pakistan-based smuggler from Amritsar Center. The accused Ghulam Rasool is a resident of Lahore. He was carrying a US-made 5.56 M4 carbine, two magazines and 28 rounds. The BSF also seized three packets of heroin weighing about 3 kg. The DSGMC has filed a criminal complaint with the police against Bollywood actor Shah Rukh Khan for hurting sentiments of the Sikh community. The complaint was filed over the trailer of the movie Zero, which shows Khan wearing a kirpan. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com. As news from Canada follows.
Immigration Terminal, the specialist for visitor visa, student visa, business immigration, family sponsorship, work permits, PNP programs, live-in caregivers and LMIA applications. Highly experienced in cases involving criminal or medical admissibility and previously refused or misrepresentation cases. Call 416-675-5666 in Ontario or 778-927-3455 in BC. Email us at info@immigrationterminal.ca. Immigration Terminal, right consultants, bright future.
Welcome back to IndianTimesDaily.com, and the top 10 headlines from Canada are: Ontario Premier Doug Ford's office has acknowledged that two high-profile departures last week were prompted by sexual misconduct allegations. Minister of the Government Jim Wilson and communications staffer Andrew Kimber had resigned from the Ford government. Two Maple Ridge residents facing extradition to India are in the BC Court of Appeal asking that their orders be declared invalid and quashed. Malkeet Sidhu and Sardeep Badesha are charged in India with conspiracy to commit murder in connection with the death of Jaswinder Sidhu. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has dismissed US President Donald Trump's argument that the duties on Canadian goods forced him to agree to a new trade deal earlier this year. Trudeau said that Canada has been open from the very beginning to negotiate a new and modernized NAFTA. People are expected to gather at viewing parties across Canada tonight to watch the American midterm elections unfold. The U.S. Consulate General in Toronto is hosting one event, which will be attended by representatives of both Democrats abroad and Republicans overseas. The Canadian Security Intelligence Service has said that many members of the environmental and Indigenous communities see the federal purchase of the Trans Mountain Pipeline as a betrayal. By agency's assessment highlights a renewed sense of indignation among protesters. The federal government will save nearly $500 million over 5 years as a result of its move away from lump sum payments to monthly pension payments for life for disabled veterans. However, Ottawa has not committed to use those savings to close compensation gaps for veterans. Canada is engaged in secret talks with allies over how to protect Asia BV. a Pakistani Christian woman who spent 8 years on death row for blasphemy. Parliamentary Secretary to the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Andrew Leslie, has confirmed the multilateral discussion. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau will join world leaders in France this weekend to commemorate the 100th anniversary of the end of the First World War. Trudeau will visit the Canadian National Vimy Ridge Memorial in northern France before attending Armistice Day ceremonies in Paris. The Transportation Safety Board of Canada is raising concerns after 17 fishermen died on board fishing vessels during the first 10 months of 2018. The number of fatalities is at an all-time high in the industry. However, a lot of the deaths were avoidable. The National Aluminium Associations of North America have urged a rapid end to tariffs within the trading bloc and aluminium products. The National Associations of Canada, Mexico and the US said tariffs should be removed before the new North American trade agreement is signed. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-Canadian businesses and resources. From accounting firms to wedding planners in your city, all of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day. Scans
Accounting. A team of highly professional accountants, we deliver quality and immeasurable assistance to our clients. For Canada audit assistance and your business loans, the only name you can trust. A professional accountant always makes a difference. For more information, call us at 416-741-0801 or visit us at scansaccountants.com.
Bollywood star Akshay Kumar has signed a slate of 3 films to be jointly produced by Fox Star Studios and Cape of Good Films. The first film to come off this partnership will be India's first space film, Mission Mangal, which is in collaboration with R. Balki. Taking to his Twitter account, Akshay Kumar shared the cast of the film and wrote, "Proud and excited to bring the story of India's Mars mission, Mission Mangal, to you." Coincidentally, the mission was launched on this very day, 5th November 2013. Meet the team and do share your best wishes for our Shubh Mangal journey. Shoot begins soon. The shoot for Mission Mangal will begin in mid-November. Mission Mangal will reunite Akshay with his Padman director R. Balki again, who will co-produce the film. After 1 year of struggle, Sushant Singh Rajput and Sara Ali Khan's star movie Kedarnath finally got a release date on 7th of December this year. The movie's teaser released on 30th October that created much buzz, be it for the film's backdrop, that of floods in Uttarakhand, or the chemistry between Sushant and debutant Saif Ali Khan's daughter, Sara Ali Khan. Now, the first song from the movie titled Namo Namo has been released. The song showcases the journey of the male lead at the shrine and how he earns through the pilgrims visiting there. Sharing the song video on Twitter, Rajput wrote, "Aaj Dhanteras ke shubh din par, Bholenath ka naam lekar, aaiye Kedarnath yatra ka aaram karte hain. Namo Namo." Shot along a 14-kilometer pilgrimage from Gaurikund to Kedarnath, the 2,000-year-old temple of Lord Shiva, the film depicts the love story of Mansoor and Mukku, played by Sushant Singh and Sara, respectively. The mountain tsunami that wrecked the temple down in June 2013, leaving thousands dead, sets the backdrop for this love story. Directed by Abhishek Kapoor and produced by RSVP and Guy, In the Sky Pictures, Kedarnath carries a tagline, "Love is a pilgrimage." The Prithvi Film Festival has commenced and whole Kapoor family made sure to mark their presence at the event. The royal couple Saif Ali Khan and Kareena Kapoor Khan were seen while making their way towards the Prithvi Film Festival, the beautiful couple wearing traditional attires for the event. At the festival, Saif was seen wearing a long black silk kurta with an ivory white coloured churidar. On the other hand, Bebo looked drop-dead gorgeous in khadi print sharara set. Saif and Kareena were seen chatty while the paparazzi clicked them. The event also saw Ila Arun, Paresh Rawal, Divya Dutta, Rohit Roy, Shibana Azmi, Neetu Chandra, Ahana Kumra, Jim Sarb, Imtiaz Ali, Shikha Thalsania, Kalki Koechlin, Lilette Dubey, Hansal Mehta, Ramesh Sippy. Superstar Shah Rukh Khan celebrated Diwali with his wife Gauri Khan and kids. However, eldest son Aryan Khan gave it a miss. An interior designer by profession, Shah Rukh Khan's wife Gauri shared a photograph with her husband on Instagram and wrote, stars in the sky, happy Diwali. Dressed in color-coordinated clothes in shades of black and gold, the couple complimented each other. In another photograph, we got to see Suhana holding Daddy and Abram smiling and posing for the camera. Gauri captioned this picture as mood lighting this Diwali. Well, aren't sure to have missed this family photograph. Meanwhile, celebrities are seen enjoying Diwali parties at their contemporaries' houses, all decked up in their best ethnic outfits. Actor Siddharth Malhotra loves Diwali festivities, but he will spend the festival this year working on his upcoming film Jabariya Jodi in Lucknow. Siddharth said in a statement to IANS, "I'm a big Diwali festival fan. However, this year I'm working on Jabariya Jodi. I am in Lucknow shooting. I will be shooting on Diwali day and will be spending time with my director and my team." For the actor, Diwali means celebrating prosperity and whatever you have, and to be happy with it. To all his fans, Siddharth has wished a safe and firecracker-free Diwali for various reasons. For no pollution, for no noise pollution, for animal safety. "I have a pet myself and Oscar becomes extremely nervous with all the sound and noises on Diwali night. So I hope we have a peaceful, quieter and a more cleaner and healthier Diwali this year."